second film is going to be that we're going to talk about is Night of the Living Dead, which is another one of my favorite movies.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
I think, personally, superior to the original, and the original is iconic and so important in the world of horror. It's famous for birthing the zombie creature as we know it today, thanks to George Romero. Even though he thought he was just filling his movie with ghouls, the other classic type of monster, a new monster of sorts was born.
Hey Simpson, I'm feeling a mite peckish. Mind if I chew your ear?
Dad, you killed the zombie Flanders.
He was a zombie?
A kind of a hybrid monster of several different, I guess it was kind of a ghoul meets a classic voodoo zombie. Put it together, and what do you got? You got The Walking Dead. And he lost the copyright, infamously. George Romero didn't make a dime, still doesn't make a dime off this movie. So this was an attempt for him to regain the copyright and to rewrite the wrong of not having that copyright mark on the original film when it was originally called, I believe, Night of the Flesh Eaters, and then they switched at the last minute, the distributor or whoever, to Night of the Living Dead. They thought it had a catchier, poppier title. In order to do that, they had to remove the copyright symbol, and boom, and history was born. And that's why you see Night of the Living Dead pop up in every movie. If somebody's watching something on the TV, it'll usually that'll be one of the movies that they're watching because it's in the public domain. They can use it for free. Night of the Living Dead has across the board better acting for sure. Dwayne Jones from the original, he was great. I believe it's Dwayne Jones, right? Is it Dwayne Jones? I don't want to mess that up because hold on a second, like. I believe it's Dwayne Jones because you have the other guy who I was thinking, it was like, is it that guy? Because they have similar names. I can't remember. The tall guy who's like, who does all the stunt work and he plays all the creatures. He played the guy like that from Pan's Labyrinth with the eyes in his hands. And he played one of the main stranger people in that Buffy episode. And he was in other Guillermo del Toro movies. Okay, I can't remember what his name is now, so I'm like afraid that, but no, I believe Dwayne Jones is the actor's name. He's the best actor in the original Night of the Living Dead, and he does a really good job. The rest of the actors are fine. They're fine. But this movie, everybody's on point. The guy in the basement, tons better. This guy is a jerk. In a way that the guy in the original wasn't. He's the dad in the basement with the family, the young daughter who winds up turning into a zombie. And ooh, Tom Knowles or Tolles or I can't remember. He works with John McNaughton a lot. He was in Henry, Portrait of a Serial Killer. I love how I'm just gonna, like, instead of say their name, I'm gonna give you their resume. But he was in Henry, and he was also in another one of my favorite movies, Stuart Gordon's Fortress. And I think his name is Tom. You can look it up. But yeah, he's great. The script is tighter. It's better. The performances and the script together, it's funnier, it's more tense. Tony Todd plays the I'm gonna say, okay, so I'm gonna say Dwayne Jones, Duncan Jones. I know Duncan Jones is like, isn't that Bowie's son? I'm all messed up right now, sorry about this. But you know what I mean, he's in that role and he is, I mean, it's Candyman. Tony Todd is always good. I'll still say till the day I die that he has not worked enough. He has not rose high enough to his greatness, to match his greatness. He should be like in every movie. But and the chemistry and back and forth he has with Patricia Tallman, who plays Barbara in this, who they basically turned into kind of like a Sarah Connor type character. She's a real badass in this movie.
Losing it, girl. You are losing it!
You think so? Whatever I lost a long time ago, and I do not plan on losing anything else. You can talk to me about losing it when you stop screaming at each other like a bunch of two-year-olds.
And she looks completely different, and Patricia Tallman is also a stunt person.
Austin, we've got to look for Dr. Evil.
Wait, I've got an idea.
Austin, why on earth did you hit that woman?
Right, let me show you, baby. That ain't no woman. It's a man.
And she does a lot of creature work. She rarely does acting jobs like this. And when she does, though, I mean, when you see her in this movie, it's like, why doesn't she act more? It's like this movie is just full of people who are just like, why aren't they in, like, all the things, everything? But she's amazing in it. I can't say enough good things about it. One of the shames about this movie, though, is that, this was also directed by Tom Savini, who did a lot of the effects work on George Romero's early Dead films. He let him direct this one. Romero took the script and produced it and things like that, but Tom Savini was directing. But the big shame, the major shame, was that the MPAA chopped the film. They gutted the film. They took all the gore out because it was originally, it's a Tom Savini film, so of course it was originally supposed to be very elaborate with this practical effects. And when you watch the movie today, it's like. You know, pales in comparison to what the original was going to be. It's going to be a lot gorier, a lot bloodier. But even with all, most of the blood and gore taken out, it's still so powerful, which really speaks to the greatness of this horror movie. One of my favorites, for sure. What else can I say about this movie? Everything is just on point and perfect and just the way it should be. So it is, let's see if they'll let me do it this time. It is a... No. Oh, I gotta get me a new app. I'm so sorry, guys. Wait, let me see here. No. Wait, I'm gonna go like this. No? Then I'm gonna move up. Oh, so we gotta like walk it up, like woo, doo, doo, and then walk up the steps, and then next thing you know, you get there. So Night of the Living Dead is a classic. So sorry about the app. I actually purchased this app too. I won't mention the name of the app as to not give them bad publicity, but I'm having some issues here. You know what? This video has gone long, and I think it's basically gone long because these two movies I have so much to say about them, and I love them so much. So there you go. So we'll see you next time in part four as we go through the greatest films of 1990, and we rank them according to where they need to be on this little tier list here. Thank you so much for showing up and watching the video. Have a good one. Bye.